Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel, Zaki Obucho, and I am here to show you my current setup, which has changed since my last video. So, in the last one, I showed you my three different Hobonichi weeks and the setup for 2021 in my weeks. Something about the Hobo Leaks that has always bugged me is the color of the paper. It's this cream color, but it's just very yellow to me. I try to edit my photos so that it's not as yellow, but in person, I mean, it is what it is, and it's pretty yellowy. I've always hoped that they would either change the Hobo Leaks so that it's on the white paper, like the A6, or like give you an option to choose what kind of paper you want, but that has not happened yet. So I love Stylogy paper. I know it's not quite as thin, but it's pretty durable. I like the way it crinkles, and it's like stark white, plus the grid on the Stylogy paper is bigger. So I have tossed around the idea for like a year now of cutting down a Stylogy, and I was going to take it to Staples to have them cut it down, which I think they do. I know like Office Max and Office Depot do that, so I just kind of assumed Staples would as well. But I never remembered. I would be out and about and I would drive past Staples and I'm like, oh, I forgot it again. So I just never ended up trying it until recently I decided to just cut it down myself. So in here we have a Stylogy. It actually was a journal, a new journal in the size B6 that I cut down to be really close to the Hobo Week size. I actually cut it twice. The first time I cut it to be a half inch wider than the Hobo Weeks. And then just the way that it fit in here, I got worried that as this bulked up, I wouldn't be able to close it. So I actually cut it down a second time, and now it's 5 millimeters wider than the Hobo Weeks. So I did that specifically because of my Giglio Appuntos. If you've ever used a Hobo Weeks in one, you'll know that it's quite a bit bigger than it needs to be for the Hobo Weeks. So I just wanted something that gave me a little bit more room on the page and also felt like I was utilizing the space in my Appuntos, the Appunto Slims that I have, a little bit more. So inside here, deco is still the same, and it's really not, I mean, this is decorative, but everything else are stickers, and I'm trying to use stickers really minimally to cut down on the bulk, because, let me grab, so this is my Hobo Weeks for 2020, which has gotten pretty thick. It's a Mega Weeks, and I didn't use any sticker kits. And I really didn't use washi until the end of the year. It was just sporadic stickers here and there, and it still bulked it up quite a bit. So given that the Stylogy already starts off thicker, I really want to try to keep that to a minimum. And then here I have just some printable vellum from Happy Scrappy over a free digital Harry Potter digital from Lindsay Scribbles. So inside here, so this was my journal. So I took just these few pages in the front. I mean, not only are they not really relevant because it's a planner now, not a journal, but a good portion of the page got cut off when I cut this down. So you can't even like read the page fully if you wanted to. So I just washi taped it shut, but I liked this little flower doodle, so I left that. Here for my yearly tracker, I printed out, this is from Peanuts Planner Co. It's a yearly tracker, and I printed it out in, I got personal size. That's the size that I bought. And then I printed it at like think 110% or something like that, and it was pretty close. So I just used double-sided tape to hold this in, and this is where to compare it to the Hobo Weeks. And I use Tombows on this. This is why it's purple and gray. But it's the same type of setup. And this is where I normally track my mood for the day, like my overall mood, and just different symptoms like migraines, panic attacks, my period, things like that. Then we have my monthlies, which are really nothing special. I have December all set up, but the other months, I haven't even written in the dates yet. My monthlies are what I use the least. It's really just like a reference for birthdays and anniversaries, and I will color code my pay periods on here as well, and like put my bills, but that's really nothing special there. Okay, so this is the first weekly that I have, and this is how I normally do things in my Hobonichi weeks. So going forward, I only drew out the left-hand side for pre-planning, just the same way that the weeks is, and then I left this side blank. But what I normally end up doing is this. So I just do like a continuation of the day. And the way that I break these down is I do absolute essential tasks and appointments go here for pre-planning. And then things that I want to do that I ended up doing and just like little notes about the day end up going over here. So this was last week because today is Monday now. So, you know, things that I absolutely had to do, a couple of work things, a little note that I worked really late that night, even though I'm working from home, you know, a CSE meeting, had to be there, really needed to catch up on documentation, my cat's medication, like those are the things that absolutely have to happen for the most part. I put laundry here just because I really wanted to do it, but I didn't walk around naked. Like, I still had clothes to wear. So, a big goal of the day also goes over here, and sometimes it gets migrated. Like, it is what it is. And then over here, I read a lot that night, and then a little note that I'm loving the book that I'm reading right now. And then things that I have to go back and do get lost for me. So I have, I put these little page flags in my 2021 weeks thinking that I would use them for like the first week of every month to find my months quickly. And even back when I still planned on using this for the year, I don't like them. They bug me. So I pulled off a few of them and I cut them in half, and I keep as like a page marker. And right now, well, I cross off the day every day. I circle the days that my cat needs his medicine. I star out the days that I've been waiting for my Vanderspeck to ship. So we just finished week 7. This is now week 8, and they usually ship right out on a Monday. So if I don't get a shipping notification today, I'm assuming it's just not in the cards for this week. And then in a really morbid way, I don't know, I track the new COVID numbers for my county down here. I've only been doing it since, a couple weeks before Thanksgiving, just because I'm a teacher. I had a feeling the way things were going that it was going to shut down, and I was having a lot of people ask me, so I figured let's just write it down. So this is a little Peanuts Planner Co. sticky note, and this is her free printable from her Facebook group. So I keep this here to mark my page, and then on the back I have those page flags. I just cut them in half, and then I pull them over here to highlight the thing that I have to go back and do. So I had my timesheet, which I do, that is on my work list and my work planner, which is a whole other thing. So once I do that, I'll come back, I'll pull this off, I'll cross off that I did it, and I'll put it back here. And then Filmstalgy video, which I am doing right now. So yeah, I use it just like my HoboLinks. It's just slightly wider and the paper's white and the paper's different. So I do have one fountain pen, the Kaweco Sport. This is the coconut one. It's like mostly see-through. And it works just fine on the Stalogy paper. I have the, Noodler's Black Eel, I think, ink. And it works great on the Stalogy paper. No issues. And I don't have to look at that yellowy color. Overall, it was a lot of work to set this up. In general, probably not super worth the time. Like, if you're in any way pressed for time or you feel like there's a lot on your plate, like, just use the HoboLinks. It's it's awesome. Like, I love my Links. If I could bleach the paper myself, like, if there's some way that I could do that, I would do it and I would be super happy. But it just, I don't know. It's just very, let me open to a blank week. I don't know how well that's going to show on camera, but it's very different. The color is very different. And it reminds me of, like, when somebody smokes indoors, like the yellow film that they get on everything. I don't know. It's bugging me right now. It has bugged me in the past, and then I got over it, and it's bugging me again. So I figure, let's do this. I mentioned before, I cut this down myself. All I used was a ruler and my husband's box cutter. It was a newer blade. I made sure that I checked with him, because I wanted the blade to be really sharp. And if you look here, I mean, you can see the ink from where I went right to the edge. But it's pretty smooth. It got a little wonky up here. And I actually cut this down twice. Like I said, I did the original cut and then I trimmed 5 centimeters off, just about. So it was smoother the first time. But this is fine for me. It doesn't bother me at all. And it just wasn't worth going to Staples and risking getting COVID right now. Like, I, in a different time, would have made a special trip a half hour away straight to Staples and had them do it, because I would want it to be perfect. But right now, it's just not worth it. So I cut it down myself and I really like it. And I did use, I have like a nail buffer block. There was at the top corner just a little bit of roughness, and I just used this, which is like $1 at the pharmacy. I have a bunch of them around here. I just used that to buff it down so it was nice and smooth, and I'm happy. So going forward, I did, similar to in the Weeks, because I've used the Weeks for so long now, I'm just like accustomed to certain things. So the months are on the side of the page here. So I went through and I did the same thing with my Tombow markers and my pen. So this is December, and then I have the week number at the top. They were originally misnumbered. That's why farther back you'll see there's two numbers. I just need to go through with an eraser and erase the second one. But yeah, so that really eliminates the need for tabs for me. The only reason I would put tabs in this would be for really important things, which would probably be in this section. So behind my monthlies and weeklies, I have a whole bunch of paper left, just like there would be in the mega weeks. So this is where things like dailies, notes, lists, maybe some journaling, and gratitude will go. My gratitude is back here, kind of private, so I'm not going to show that, but I do keep a daily gratitude log, and I did that all through last year. It was the first time that I did it, and it really helped like change how I look at the day overall. Like, instead of just today sucked, identifying at least one good thing that happened, even if it's just like when my dog laid his head in my lap. Like, that just warms my heart. I love that. Those are such wonderful moments, and they make everything better. Or, you know, holding hands with my husband. Like, everything feels okay when I have that. So little things like that that you look for and identify throughout even your worst days, it can really change your perspective on things. So yeah, so that's what this section is for. Now, I do have a separate journal, which is a B6stalgy in this Giglio B6 Anthracite Appunto. Super personal, really no reason to go showing anything in here, but that is my designated journal. And then I have a reading journal right here where I just put thoughts about books and my favorite quotes from them as kind of like a massive collection. And this is an A6 Stalogy. And this is a little Kaweco Sport clicky rollerball pen. It is the like the cousin of this fountain pen that I have. And then, of course, I have this week's nearby just for reference for this video. But yeah, and then I have my work planner, but I don't, like, if somebody was like, oh, do a planner stack, I probably wouldn't even think to put my work planner in it. It's a Wonderland 222 B6-sized weekly planner, and it's nothing special. It's full of private information, so I can't really show it. But, so I probably won't do a ton of journaling in here just because I have a designated journal, and this is what I take places. This is what I would potentially accidentally leave behind. So I don't want really private things to be in here. But maybe like little things that I wouldn't mind other people knowing I might write in here. I haven't written anything yet. I've just been using the weeklies. And then normally my last few pages I would use as my lists, but I have, so pen test has to be in here because it needs to be on the Stalogy paper. And this pen right here is the one that I am using. It's the, Pentel Energel Philography, and it uses the Energel 0.5, I believe. Needle tip refills, and this is warm gray, warm silver, something like that. I thought it matched really well with my Grigio Ostrich X leather, and yeah, so works really well. I like it a lot. And then my Muji is Old Faithful. That's my go-to after this one. So, I would normally have lists in the back there, but I made, this little insert is from Hobonichi. It's like to go with the weeks, and I had a pack of them, just sitting around. So I decided to take this and, just put some, stationery paper, scrapbook paper, that's what it's called. It was leftovers from this that I slipped in this cover, to cover up the ugly, it was like a sky blue cover for this little insert, and this is where I'm going to have all of my lists, and that way I don't have to rewrite them. So if I change my mind and I want to go to my Hobo Weeks and I haven't written something in my Hobo Weeks, it won't matter. Like, this will just be in the back. because I don't see myself leaving this size. It's worked so well for me for so long that I can't picture that happening. So I will keep this little insert and just carry it from year to year, from, you know, between the Stalogy and the Hobo Weeks, whatever. And then back here, I just have a little ruler, which is from Philopax, and some, they're like sticky notes, but they're not sticky. They just came off of a little notepad that are seasonal, and that's pretty much it. I wanted to wait until I had this like pretty much completely set up to do this video, but it's pretty basic. I mean, it's just like the Hobo Weeks, really. It doesn't have the like the top 100 or whatever in the back, which I usually use that for a collection of books and movies. So this is my 2020 right here. So this, I will just make a page in that little booklet that says favorite books and favorite shows and put these on there and just keep adding to it. So this will just be another like reference page that normally would be in the back of my weeks that now is just in that little insert. And then, you know, the Hobo Weeks has a lot of pages that I can't read because I only can read English. That I don't know would ever really be relevant to my life, and even if I could read it, and definitely are just there without serving any purpose for me. So my Stalogy doesn't have any of that, so those are just empty grid pages to be used for something more relevant to me and myself and my life. So yeah, that's it. That's what I'm using. That's what's working. I'm still in my Grigio cover. I do want to do an update video on that, but I want to give it a few more weeks. I have like this weird ritual every night where I rub my planner because sometimes I just don't have it in my hands a whole lot. And I really want to see how the ostrich leather will patina. So I'm trying, guys. I'm trying to really put this to the test and see what I think of it more long term, aside from just the first impressions video that I made. So I will eventually do an update of that. I might do a video on my different systems that I have going right now that I just gave you a brief glimpse of today. And I'm thinking I might do a video on like my 2020 planning and just the different things that I tried because I wasn't a Hobo Weeks. I was in a basic Stalogy in the more, I think, common way of using it, with the tippins and the like the dailies, and I was using this as a planner. We've been through a few things this year. I went right back to my Hobo Weeks. But there was a purpose, like things came of it. And I think it would be fun to share that journey. So I will definitely have some videos up in the near future. I want to get them done before the new year. I'm actually filming this in between Zoom lessons with students right now. I had a little bit of a break, so I wanted to get this filmed while I still have daylight. So I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know what you think. And definitely let me know if you cut your Stalogy down yourself. I'm definitely not the first one to cut down a Stalogy. I'm not the first one to cut it down by hand. But I think doing as much for yourself as you can at home right now is important to keep your loved ones safe and healthy and yourself and just the general public. like making a special trip to an office store to have a notebook cut down when you could just try it at home. You know, maybe not totally worth it. So that's my thinking on the whole thing. So I'd be really interested to know if you guys have done it or if you're thinking about it. If you have any questions, let me know. Other than, you know, holding the ruler down really firmly and making your long slices with your box cutter, I really don't have any advice. Have a steady hand and be careful. Don't cut yourself. I can't give anybody advice on using a knife. Just the look of pure terror in my husband's eyes when he hands me something sharp. Like, that says everything. Yeah, just be careful. And you can always buy another Stalogy. Like, it's a lot cheaper to buy another Stalogy than it is to go to the hospital with COVID. However, going to the hospital because you need stitches is not cheap and not good either. So just be careful if you decide to try it. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And I thank you for dealing with my new slight lisp that I have. I should have mentioned this in the beginning. I have Invisalign braces right now, and I feel ridiculous. Nobody ever has to see my mouth because I have a mask on all the time, but it does make me a little bit lispy. So thank you for bearing with me. It's like a 6-month project, so my other videos are gonna have it as well. But I appreciate your compassion and understanding if it's a little bit cringy. So thank you all so much for joining me. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.